As previously stated, the two methods other than the census for obtaining information are sampling and experimentation. As we are already aware that the sampling error cannot be avoided, we should try to eliminate or minimize the non-sampling error. Next, we will discuss the sampling designs and different biases. One example of a non-sampling error is a sampling bias caused by the sampling method. In plain language, sampling bias is a measure of how not representative is the sample. One way to minimize the bias is to use a sampling procedure for which each possible sample of a given size is equally likely to be the one obtained. Such a procedure is called simple random sampling. And the sample obtained from using such procedure is called a simple random sample. So how exactly does one obtain a simple random sample? Let's pick a random sample of size 5. One way to arrange that is to have everyone write their names on a piece of paper and put it in a hat, and then randomly draw 5 pieces of paper from the hat. We can classify the sampling based on whether the used piece of paper goes back in the hat or not. One is a sampling with replacement, where a member of the population can be selected more than once. The other is sampling without replacement, where a member of the population can be selected at most once. Unless we specify otherwise, a simple random sampling is done without replacement. Technically, it is harder to perform the sampling without replacement as it requires additional effort of tracking and making sure the choices do not repeat. However, when a sample is less than 5% of the population size, the difference in results is almost negligible. But when the population is small or the sample size is large in relation to the size of the population, there could be instances when with or without replacement matters. Let's decide whether a sampling with or without replacement is more appropriate in the following scenario. A teacher picks a random sample of 10 students to answer 10 questions throughout the duration of the class. I'd say that sampling with replacement is more appropriate in this case, because as a teacher, you don't want a student to think that he or she can't be picked again after he or she was already picked once. Let's consider another example and decide whether a sampling with or without replacement is more appropriate. A teacher picks a random sample of 10 students to attend a conference. I'd say that sampling without replacement is more appropriate in this case, because a teacher can't take the same student more than once on the same trip. Obtaining a simple random sample by picking slips of paper out of a box or hat is usually impractical, especially when the population is large. Fortunately, we can use several practical procedures to get simple random samples. One common method involves a table of random numbers. However, nowadays, computers can easily replace the table. A simple random sampling is the most natural and easily understood method of sampling. It corresponds to our intuitive notion of random selection by lot. However, simple random sampling does have its drawbacks. For instance, it may fail to provide sufficient coverage or may be impractical when the members of the population are widely scattered geographically. Next, we will examine some other commonly used sampling procedures that are often more practical than a simple random sampling. All sampling techniques can be classified as random or probability sampling and non-random or non-probability sampling. Probability sampling is a sampling technique in which the subjects of the population get an equal opportunity to be selected as a representative sample, which is not the case with a non-probability sampling. Let's assume that there are 35 desks in the classroom arranged in 5 rows with 7 desks in each row. The following diagrams illustrate the differences between random and non-random sampling of 11 students. We discussed the simple random sampling, which is the ideal sampling method for producing the least biased sample. Next, we will examine some other commonly used random and non-random sampling procedures.